Yet the railroads and the country continue to grow. Time zones are standardized, and new inventions like air brakes make trains safer. But as America races into the 20th century, competition calls for more and more speed. It's become a point of honor for trainmen to keep on schedule. One of them will die for this creed, and a song will make him a legend. Come all you rounders if you want to hear a story about a brave engineer. Casey Jones was the roller's name. On a big ten wheeler, boys, he won his fame. Caller called Casey about a 4:30. Kissed his wife by the station door. Climbed in the cabin with his orders in his hand. Took his trip to the promised land. Casey Jones climbed in the cabin. Casey Jones, orders in his hand. Casey Jones, leaning out the window, taking a trip to the promised land. Through South Memphis, yards on the fly, rain been a-falling and the water was high. Everybody knew by the engine's moan, the man at the throttle was Casey Jones. Jones said, fireman, don't you fret. Sim Webb said, I ain't a-giving up yet. We're 8 hours late with the southbound mail. We'll be on time or we're leaving the rail. Dead on the rail was a passenger train. Blood was a-boiling in Casey's brain. Casey said, hey now, look out ahead. Jump, Sim, jump or we'll all be dead. With a hand on the whistle and a hand on the brake, Vaughn, Mississippi was wide awake. I see railroad officials said, he's a good engineer to be a-laying dead. Well, they gave him his orders at Monroe, Virginia. Said, Steve, you're way behind time. This is not 38, this is 097. Put her in suspensor on time. It's a mighty rough road from Lynchburg to Danville in a line on a 3 mile grade. It was on that grade that he lost his air brake. See what a jump he made. He was going down a grade, making 90 miles an hour, and a whistle broke into a scream. He was found in the wreck with his hand on the throttle, scalded to death by the steam. Headaches and heartaches and all kind of pain are all a part of a railroad train. The sweat and the toil, the good and the grand, are part of the life of a railroad man.
Yonder coming, coming down that railroad track. Hey, look yonder coming, coming down that railroad track. It's the Orange Blossom Special, bringing my baby back. We'll be right back.
Say, man, when are you going back to Florida?
When am I going back to Florida? I don't know. I don't reckon I ever will.
Ain't you worried about getting your nourishment in New York?
Oh, I don't care if I do die, do die, do die, do die, do die.
Hey, talk about a rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. Talk about a travel. She's the fastest train on the line. It's that orange blossom special rolling down the seaboard line. Whoa, whoa.
Now this here's a story about the Rock Island Line. Well, the Rock Island Line, she runs down into New Orleans. There's a big toll gate down there, and you know, if you got certain things on board when you go through the toll gate, well, you don't have to pay the man no toll. Well, a train driver, he pulled up to the toll gate, and the man hollered and asked him what all he had on board, and he said, I got livestock, I got livestock, I got cows, I got pigs, I got sheep, I got mules, I got all livestock. Well, they said, you all right, boy. You don't have to pay no toll, you can just go right on through. So he went on through the toll gate, and as he went through, he started picking up a little bit of speed, picking up a little bit of steam. He got on through, he turned, looked back to man, he said, well, I fooled you, I fooled you, I got pig iron, I got pig iron, I got all pig iron. Down the Rock Island Line, she's a mighty good road. Rock Island Line, it's a road to ride. Rock Island Line, it's a mighty good road. Well, if you ride, you got to ride it like you find it, get your ticket at the station for the Rock Island Line. Oh, cloudy in the west and it looked like rain. Round the curve come a passenger train. Northbound train on the southbound track. He's all right, leaving, but he won't be back. Well, the Rock Island Line, she's a mighty good road. Rock Island Line, it's a road to ride. Rock Island Line, it's a mighty good road. Well, if you ride, you got to ride it like you find it. Get your ticket, that's your station for the Rock Island Line. Well, I may be right and I may be wrong, but you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. Well, the engineer said before he died, there were two more drinks that he'd like to try. Conductor said, what could they be? A hot cup of coffee and a cold glass of tea. Well, the Rock Island Line, she's a mighty good road. Rock Island Line, it's a road to ride. Rock Island Line, it's a mighty good road. Well, if you ride, you got to ride it like you find it. Get your ticket at the station for the Rock Island Line.
Coming through, pulling cars for passengers like you. If you want to take this trip, the fare is free. So get on board and ride the rails with me. Riding the rails. Riding the rails. Riding the rails. Riding the rails. There once was a man whose name I do not know, and he decided horses were too slow. But to turn a wheel it took more than a dream, so he boiled the water and harnessed up the steam. Riding the rail. Riding the rail.
great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore. She climbs the flowery mountains or the hills and by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome, she's known quite well by all. She's a regular combination on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland or the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear those lonesome hobos call, traveling through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Well, she came down from Birmingham one cold December day. As she pulled into the station, you could hear all the people say, she's from Tennessee, she's long and she's tall. She came down from Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland or the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear those lonesome hobos call, traveling through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Here's the Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand and always be remembered in the courts throughout the land. His earthly race is over and the curtains round him fall. They'll carry him home to Dixie on the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland or the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear those lonesome hobos call, traveling through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Cross the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. I know a land where mountain streams are running free. I know a prairie where there's miles between each tree. I know where there's people you would like to get to know. Come along with me and go. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Cross the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. I heard a story that I'd like to share with you. I know a valley that I'd like to take you through. I will show you things that I am sure you'd like to see. Come along and go with me. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Cross the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Cross the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train.
Mm. 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 pappy woke him up one midnight. He said, "Before the sheriff comes, I want to tell you, listen, boy." Said, "Learn to ball a jack, learn to lay a track, learn to pick and shovel too, and take my hammer. It'll do anything you tell it to." John Henry's mammy had about a dozen babies. John Henry's pappy broke jail about a dozen times. The babies all got sick, and when the doctor wanted money, he said, "I'll pay you a quarter at a time. Starting tomorrow, that's a pay for a steel driver on his line." Then the section foreman said, "Hey, hammer swinger, I see you brought your own hammer, boy, but what else can all them muscles do?" And he said, "I can turn a jack, I can lay a track, I can pick and shovel too.
Can you swing a hammer, boy?"
"Yes, sir, I'll do anything you hire me to."
"Now, ain't you something so high and mighty with your muscle? Just go ahead, boy, and pick up that hammer. Pick up the hammer."
He said, "Get a rusty spike and swing it down three times. I'll pay you a nickel a day for every inch you sink it to. Go on and do what you say you can do." With a steep-nosed hammer on a four-foot switch handle, John Henry raised it back till it touched his heels. And the spike went through the cross tie and it split it half in two. 35 cents pay for driving steel.
Sweat, sweat, boy, sweat. You owe me two more swings.
I was born for driving steel. Well, John Henry hammered in the mountain. He'd give a grunt, he'd give a groan with every swing. The women folks for miles around heard him and come down to watch him make the cold steel ring. Lord, what a swinger! Just listen to that cold steel ring. But the bad boss come up laughing at John Henry. Said, "You full of vinegar now, but you bout through. We gonna get a steam drill to do your share of driving. Then what's all them muscles gonna do, huh, John Henry? Gonna take a little bit of vinegar out of you." John Henry said, "I feed four little brothers and baby sisters walking on her knees. Did the Lord say that machines ought to take the place of living? And what's a substitute for bread and beans? I ain't seen it. Do engines get rewarded for their steam?" John Henry hid in a coal mine for his dinner nap. Had 30 minutes to rest before the bell. The mine boss hollered, "Get up, whoever you are, and get a pickaxe. Give me enough coal to start another hell and keep it burning. Mine me enough to start another hell." John Henry said to his captain, "A man ain't nothing but a man. But if you bring that steam drill around, I'll beat it fair and honest. I'll die with my hammer in my hand, but I'll be laughing, 'cause you can't replace a steel driving man." There was a big crowd of people at the mountain. John Henry said to the steam drill, "How is you?" "Pardon me, Mr. Steam Drill, I suppose you didn't hear me." "I said, how you? Huh? Well, can you turn a jack? Can you lay a track? Can you pick and shovel too? Listen, this hammer swinger's talking to you." 5,000 people hollered,
"Go, John Henry!"
Then somebody hollered,
"The mountain's caving in!"
John Henry told the captain, "Tell the kind folks don't to worry. It ain't nothing but my hammer sucking wind. It keeps me breathing. This steel driver's muscle, I ain't tin." Captain, tell the people move back further. I'm at the finish line and there ain't no drill. It's so far behind, but yet ain't got the brains to quit it. When she blows up, she'll scatter across the hills, Lord, Lord. When she blows up, she'll scatter across the hills. Well, John Henry had a little woman. I believe the lady's name was Polly Ann. Yeah, that was his good woman. John Henry threw his hammer over his shoulder and went on home. He lay down to rest his weary back, and early next morning he said, "Come here, Polly Ann. Come here, sugar. You know, I believe this is the first time I ever watched the sun come up that I couldn't come up. Take my hammer, Polly Ann, and go to that railroad. Swing that hammer like you seen me do it. And when you're swinging with the lead man, they'll all know. They'll all know you're John Henry's woman, but tell them that ain't all you can do. Tell them, I can hoist a jack and I can lay a track. I can pick and shovel too. Ain't no machine can. That's been proved to you." There was a big crowd of mourners at the church house. The section hands laid him in the sand. Trains go by on the rails John Henry laid. They slow down, they take off the hats, the men do, when they come to the place where John Henry's laying, resting his back. Some of them say, "Morning, steel driver. You sure was a hammer swinger." Then they go on by, picking up a little speed. Clickety-clack, 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 clickety-clack.
Yonder lies a steel driving man.